We are in section 19.2, application of Fourier series. Basically, there are just two examples. So both are periodic waves and both are of positive signs. But one difference is that one is a square wave with a discontinuous wave profile. The other is so-called full-wave rectifier, basically is an absolute value of a sine wave. Okay, so and there's when you calculate the Fourier series, the amplitude, the coefficient dependence on the mode number will be have a different power. So we'll basically see that in these two examples. So the first one is 19.2.1. So, okay, and the wave profile is basically a square wave. So, so this is X, and that is the wave profile F. So basically, it's of a level H, and then this is from 0 to pi, and then from pi to 2 pi is 0. Likewise, from negative pi to 0 is 0, and then repeat the pattern like that. Okay, so that is a square wave, so I'm writing the function as h for. You use the domain minus pi to pi, and then zero. This is from zero, and then it's from zero to pi. Okay, so and this profile looks like there's no symmetry, and after we get it, then we see that there actually is a symmetry. Pretty obviously, you can see that. But let's do the calculation. So the cosine series, the coefficient A, and we separate the mode n equals 0 and non-zero mode. So the A0 is given by 1 over pi. So you integrate from minus pi to pi, but for minus pi to 0 is 0. So basically you integrate from 0 to pi, and then the amplitude is h. And then cosine 0 is 0, so it's basically just h and dx. Okay, so this is basically integrate, you get pi and cancel with pi, so this basically is just h. All right, and for all other magnitude a sub n is 1 over pi 0 to pi, and integrate over this f, which is just h times cosine n x dx. Okay, and that after you do the integration, you get 1 over n pi and sine of n x, evaluate 0 to pi. But the sine n pi is 0 and sine 0 is 0. So this is exactly 0 for all. This is n equals to 1, 2, 3, etc. So all the non-zero power, non-zero order of a sub n, so zero. So basically this show that this is look like only a sine, only like a sine called Fourier sine series, except a zero term, which basically just means that if you change that the level, if you like f decrease by a level of h over 2, then this f becomes an odd function, or f minus h over 2 is an odd function, so you only have a sine term, or f is just h over 2 plus a sine series. Okay, so h over 2 is a zero term. So what is left are the sine coefficient of the sine series. So you have, can do the same thing, 0 to pi h, now you multiply by sine n x dx. This is h, but it doesn't matter, it's 0. This become h over n pi and cosine of n pi minus sine and 0 to pi, which is equals to 1 over n pi. The lower limit is 1, the upper limit is this nx. Okay, the upper limit is minus 1 to the power of n. So minus 1 to the power of n. Okay, so it will be n is again from 1 to positive or the positive integer. So for n is even, then it will be 0. For n is odd, this will be 2. Okay, so if you combine everything, so then you can write fx as the a zero term divided by 2, which is h over 2. So let me just write h over 2 here. H over 2, and then plus the sine term. All the sine are proportional to 2 over pi, and there's an h chosen. 2h over pi, and now you have sum over n from 1 to infinity, but the n is odd, only all the odd term, and the sine of nx divided by n. Okay. So that's the result, which is equation 19.26. Okay, so you see that the magnitude, the coefficient for the sine series is proportional to n. So so as high frequency or high mole number, that amplitude decrease less rapidly because it's just 1 over n. So you have many higher frequency mole in this square wave. Okay, so that's the first example. The second example is 19.2.2. So it's a four-way rectifier. Basically, f is it's just absolute value of sine omega t. Okay, and now the period, you can write it at t or using multiply by omega. So you can write it like this is from minus pi to pi. Okay, so it's the after you multiply by omega, basically normalize the time. So omega times t is have a periodicity, just like the what we assume in the Fourier series formula. Okay, so then we can apply the formula directly. So graphically, this is just like a sine, but then zero to, this is from 0 to pi, but then you take the absolute value original sine wave is like that, so you take the absolute value, so it becomes like that. So you can keep the periodic wave like that. Okay, so because of this taking absolute value, this is a even function. So you expect you only have the cosine term, right? So to get the cosine term, then you can multiply it by the cosine function, but then there's a one term is a zero is separately, so a zero is just 1/pi integrating zero to pi, but you multiply by two because this is an even function, and the wave is sine w sine omega t, and now you don't cosine zero is one, so you only integrate d omega t. Okay, so that would give you basically this is what you get is 2/pi minus 2/pi cosine of omega t, and omega t evaluates 0 to pi, and cosine pi is negative 1, cosine 0 is 1, so you get the, this would be equals to 4/pi. Okay, so that's a 0, so that's the separate term. So, and the other a sub n is 2/pi, integrate from 0 to pi and sine omega t. Now you multiply by the cosine term, cosine nx. Actually, it should be x is our omega t, multiply by cosine omega t and t omega t. Okay, and this kind of integration, of course, you can, again, very simple, you can look up a table, integration table or math handbook. But another way to do this is using a formula in addition or multiplication of trigonometric function or two trigonometric function and reduce that to two trigonometric function, and the formula will sine time cosine will be 1/2 of the sine a plus b plus sine a minus b, so that would be with the 1/pi cancel the two, so integrate 0 to pi, there will be two terms, one is sine, this is 1, and this is n, so 1 plus n omega t, and then the other is sine 1 minus n omega t. Omega t. Okay, so it would be the formula, and then we do the integration directly. This both term will give you cosine, and with a negative sign, so you have negative cosine of 1 plus n omega t. And divided by 1 plus n plus sine of 1 minus n omega t 1 minus n. and then evaluate from 0 to pi, omega t equals 0 to pi. This is not sine, this is cosine. Okay. And now the again cosine for the lower limit cosine 0 is always 1, and cosine of n pi is minus 1 to the n power, but this now you have 1 plus n or 1 minus n, so both will be of the same sign, because depends on whether or n is odd or even. That depends on that both terms will be of the same sign. So if n is odd, then odd plus 1 will be even. And even over the minus 1 to the even power will be 1, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So that would be 0. So for all odd n, we'll get 0. But for even n, then the minus 1 to the odd number is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 will be minus 2, and then cancel the minus sign, will be 2 over pi. Okay, so equals to 0 for n is odd. Okay, and then you have 2 over pi times 2 over pi, and then you have 1 plus n plus 1 minus n. And you can simplify that. You get a common denominator, we'll get 1 minus n squared times 2. Okay. So we totally is 4 over pi 1 minus n squared 2 over pi 1 minus n squared. So this is 4 n even. Okay, so that's the second example. So all the terms will be now fx will be a 0 over 2 before over, so divided by 2 will be 2 over pi, and then all these terms will be plus sum over n from 1 to infinity, and the coefficient is 2 over n squared and cosine n omega t. Okay, so that would be your equation. Actually not 2 or 4, because you have 2 and then multiply 2 is 4. Okay, and now the main idea is that now the f, the coefficient of cosine function now is for at least for large n is proportional to 1 of n squared, and this is compared with the previous example with the magnitude proportion of 1 over n. So the second example, the mode, the amplitude of the mode decreases faster, so you have less high frequency wave in this example, and the convergence will be faster. And also this is due to the fact that this function is continuous, except that the derivative is not continuous. The first example, the function itself is discontinuous, so that basically determined the dependency on n or the Fourier coefficient. Okay, and so that would be the second example. And the rest of this section is just a table of some of the Fourier series mentioned in the first two sections, or maybe include some of the exercises also. Okay, so that's all for this section.